Hello, I'm using the Live Link Face app to animate
my Metahuman and transfer that animation onto any stylized character.
Oh, and you can change out your characters super easily with a click of a button.
This is pretty cool. So yeah, join me on a tutorial on how to do this.
Hello, welcome back to another Prompt Muse tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use the Live Link Face app to transfer animations from your face to your custom character easily within Unreal Engine. In my previous video, I went over the brand new tool, which is the UECC rig. This plugin will convert your characters out of Character Creator or iClone into characters that have a control rig, which means we can now transfer Metahuman animations or UE skeleton animations onto this control rig. Not only will I be showing you how to add the facial animation to your custom character, I'm also going to be showing you how to add body animation and where to get some free body animation. So I'm going to jump straight in and go through the list of software and plugins that you need to do this. So the only paid for product is Character Creator, and we'll be using this to create our character and then export it into Unreal Engine. There's currently 40% off Character Creator, and there's also a 30-day trial as well for those that want to just test this out. You obviously need Unreal Engine and download Quixel Bridge, and you will need to go to the Epic Store Marketplace and download CC Rig. We're also going to be using Metahuman, so just ensure that from the Marketplace you install the Metahuman plugin to the engine that you're going to be using. We'll also be using the Unreal AutoSetup, which will allow us to export our characters from Character Creator to Unreal Engine easily. All the plugins up here are pretty easy to install, but I think the AutoSetup tool just needs a little bit of guidance. So I've added on the beginning of this tutorial on how to install that plugin. You will also need an Apple iPhone because we're going to be using the Live Link Face app from Unreal Engine, which is absolutely free on the App Store. So you can go ahead and download that. All the links are in the description below. Essentially, AutoSetup is a bridge from Character Creator to Unreal Engine, which means that all your materials and everything will be supported, so you don't have to mess around with those. It's an import tool. To start off with, we need to start an Unreal project because we're going to be putting the AutoSetup files within that project itself once it's created. So you just need to go and launch Unreal Engine, and I'm just going to do a blank document and give it a name that I'm going to remember and click on create. Okay, so now your project is created. We want to close this project down. You just got to ensure this project is closed down because we're going to be installing stuff in the back end. So we're just going to head to the Real Illusion website where we can download this AutoSetup for free. Link is in my description. Just download that and it will end up in your downloads folder as a zip. Unzip that download and then run the setup exit file from there. Once that's run, you'll see you now have loads of different folders. These folders correspond with the version of Unreal Engine that you are using. I'm using 5.4, so I'm going to go into that folder and I'm going to select the contents folder and the plugins folder and right click them and copy. Actually, I'm going to cut and then I'm going to move them into another folder. I'm going to move the content and plugin folder into my Unreal Engine project, which is in Documents, Unreal Engine, and then whatever you named your project a second ago. Mine was AutoSetup Tutorials. So I'm just going to paste them in there. Now it's going to ask you if you want to replace these files. You do. You want to click yes on that. Okay, that's it. We are now installed. You can double left click the .u project in this folder and this will take you into your project itself. It's just a quick way. Upon launching Unreal Engine, you'll notice on the top horizontal toolbar you have a new icon. This is your new auto setup icon. So we're now ready to go into Character Creator and grab our custom character. In Character Creator, in the scene panel, I'm just going to ensure my character is selected and go to File, Export, FBX and Close Character. From the top drop down target tool preset, I'm going to select Unreal Engine. And I actually haven't got any motion on this character. So from the FBX option, I'm going to just export mesh and I'm just going to delete hidden faces and then click on export and we're done. Okay, so we're going to now jump into Unreal Engine. And when we're here, we're just going to make sure that CC control rig is installed. So we want to go up to the top right hand corner to settings and from the drop down list plugins. And then in the plugins dialog search bar, just type in character. And then from here, you should be able to see the Character Creator UE control rig. Now, if you don't see the UECC control rig, that means you didn't install it to the engine. So go back to the Epic Games Marketplace and just make sure that you install that to the engine, and then it will appear on this list. You also want to ensure that you've got Live Link installed, so just type it in the search bar and find Live Link, as well as Apple ARKit and Apple AR Face Support as well. Finally, if you just search for Metahumans, check that box and then restart now where prompted at the bottom of the screen. So we're going to come into the content drawer and right click anywhere and create a new folder. This is where we're going to import our character into. So just give it a name and then click into the folder. From here, you can see this little import button. You can click that and import your FBX, which you exported out of Character Creator. I'm going to select the high quality shader where prompted. And then in the FBX import options, if you drop down the menu underneath Advanced, you should see Use T0 as Ref Pose. Give that a check and check Import Morph Targets as well. And then click Import All. Okay, now find your skeletal mesh and right click on it. Click on Create CC Control Rig, which is nearer to the bottom of the pop-up menu, and this will generate your CC rig automatically. It's that easy. Okay, now once that's done that, it will generate a folder within your folder called rigs, and this is where your CC underscore rig underscore BP is going to be. This is what we're going to be using to primarily place all our animations onto. So we need to put this blueprint class into our scene, so just left click and drag into your scene here. We now need to add a sequencer, and you can kind of think of this as your timeline or where you're going to record all your animations. So if you go up to the top hand screen to that little clipboard and then click on add level sequence, this will be essentially the name of our timeline. So give that a name and click on save. That's open at the bottom here. You can see on this tab sequencer, and we need to add our character into that timeline. We're going to go into our outliner on the top right hand corner and left click and drag the CC rig BP into this sequencer. So next we're going to be adding a metahuman to our scene. We're basically going to be using the face app on our phone to record live to our metahuman and take that data and copy and paste it to our control rig, and it's pretty easy. So all we need to do now is go up to Windows and Quixel Bridge and import a metahuman. It can be any metahuman. You don't have to fuss over what it looks like whatsoever. It doesn't even need hair. In fact, it's probably better if it doesn't have hair. When you select your metahuman, you will see on the right hand side you get this card. From the drop down window, you can select the quality of your metahuman. You can just select low quality and then add that to your scene. To add your metahuman into your Unreal project, you just go to the characters card and press the little blue arrow, and that will add it to your Unreal project. We are now done with Quixel Bridge, so you can go and close that window. And you can now see in your content browser you have a metahuman folder here, and find the BP underscore whatever your character's name is, and then drag that alongside your character in the scene. Okay, so we're now ready to connect to our Unreal Engine Face app, which is here. If you click on the button once it's installed and click on the Live Link AR, which is the top option, and click continue. To ensure connectivity between your app and your computer, you need the IP address within the Live Link settings targets to be the same as your network IP on your computer. If you need guidance for this, I have left a troubleshooting link in the description below. We're now going to connect our metahuman with our iPhone. To do that, you need to make sure that your metahuman is selected. Go to the outliner and select BP underscore whatever your character is. Come down and under the details panel, just make sure you're on the all tab. Go down and you should see a live link option, and then underneath that, if you expand that, you've got AR face subject. From that drop down window, select your iPhone, and then underneath that, check the use AR face. Now if you get hair like this where you can't actually see the face of the character, yeah, that's annoying, but it's an easy fix. Uncheck and then recheck the use AR face kit, and that should reset the hair, so you shouldn't have a problem. So now find your metahuman in the outline. It will be BP underscore whatever your character is called, and then left click and drag that into the sequencer, much like we did with our custom character previously. So now you have two characters in your sequencer. You probably have noticed as soon as you drag your character into the sequencer, the facial connection between your phone and the metahuman has stopped working. Do not worry, that's fine. If you just go into your body and delete the metahuman control rig, as well as underneath face, that's the most important one, delete the face control board rig as well. Okay, so we are going to start animating. So if you select your character here and then click the red record button and then you'll have a 3-second countdown. I'm just going to switch to the Unreal Live Link face app and record. I'm going to be showing you how easy it is to transfer Metahuman animation over to a CC control rig. Okay, once you're finished, click on stop. If you want to know where that animation sequence has saved to, you can either click the browse to button down here, but that disappears very quickly. So it's actually kept in your content browser and in content and animation, and this is where you see all the sequences or animations that you have created with your iPhone. If we hop back into the sequencer tab here, you can now see here, if you scrub along the timeline, you can now see that your facial animation has been recorded. So next we're going to be baking the animations into keyframes so we can copy them. What we need to do before we do that is set the start of our play animation by going down here and pressing this green line, and that's the start of the animation, and then where we want the animation to end, so press this red end button so you can crop out any bits that you don't like. And another reason I do it as well, because when you're baking it will actually crash your project if you don't set the start and the end, and just don't make the animation too long because it's quite resource intensive when baking. To bake, you simply go to the face underneath your character and then right click on this and go bake to control rig, and then you need to choose the face control board control rig here and click on that. It will give you some options. You don't need to do anything here, it's all default, it's fine. Click on create, and this is going to take like 5 minutes or whatever, however long. Okay, that was really quick. That's going to take a few seconds to bake that animation, and now you can see we have the keyframes that we want. You can also see on the control rig face board, you can see all the movements of the face. Okay, so now we've baked those keyframes, if we come down on our Metahuman face and underneath face underscore control board, you can see the keyframes there. Now we can right click on that and go to copy, and simply go to our character or our custom character, select it and come down here and go to the face, and go to CC underscore face rig, right click and paste. And you can see there that the frames paste perfectly onto our custom character. Another thing that you can do is save it as a FBX file. So if we come back here to our Metahuman character, come back down to her face, right click, and we can then export and simply save your FBX facial animation here, which you can use on multiple characters. Now to import that back on your character, just come back to your custom character, right click on the CC face rig, go up to import, and then select that file. It is actually super simple. And to show you how nicely it works, I'm just going to switch the Metahuman back on here and just play them both in tandem so you can see the animations playing together. And you can see how it's transferred pretty nicely onto that stylized character. On my last video, somebody asked me the question, can you do anthropomorphic characters? Yes, you can. Thank you so much to the user who posed that question, and here's the outcome of that
this
test.
This is a test.
Let's take a quick look at how we can customize these keyframes even further. I've just added another viewport here so I can focus on the face rig. This is all very rudimental, but hopefully you can see what I'm doing here. In the sequencer under face, you should see CC underscore face underscore rig. Click the plus arrow next to it over on the right hand side of it and select adaptive from the pop-up window. This adds a new animation layer where we can record new keyframes. Scrub along the timeline to the section you want to edit. When you reach the desired point, stop and move over to the facial rig board on the top right panel of the screen. Use the dots as controllers to adjust the facial animation. I'm just going to add a bit of a lip curl here. Once you're happy with the adjustment, press S on the keyboard. This will set a new keyframe for you in your additive layer. I'm just adding another keyframe to bring the lower lip down so it starts up low and then goes up high and then comes back down low again. So you can go through and tweak your animation like this. I'm quite aware that the control rig as well as the control rig facial board looks intimidating to use when you first lay eyes on it, but it is actually very easy to get your head around, and once you've got this workflow down, it's the quickest and easiest way I can think of how to do facial animation in Unreal Engine, especially on custom characters. You can easily add animation to your character's body, whether you're getting it from motion capture or you're using iClone to create your animation. It's easily imported onto this CC rig. There are many places that you can pick up animation. You can get it from the ActorCore library by Real Illusion. They have some great animations and you can search for specific animations on there. Currently, there are 500 free animations that you can grab from the Epic Games Marketplace now. And you'll find this project in the Epic Games Marketplace under the Game Animation Sample Project. So I'm going to do a quick demo on how to grab these animations out for the project and apply them onto your character. So the first thing is to create a project. Once that has downloaded, go into your library or your recent projects, and here you'll find a Game Animation Sample. Open that up. Go down to your content drawer to open up your content browser, and we're going to go underneath all content, characters, UEFN mannequin, and then animations underneath there, and then you've got a load of free animations that we can steal. So we're going to steal an idol. To preview the animation, you just double left click on the animation and it will give you a preview screen. Don't be scared of the screen, you're just using it just to see what the animation looks like. Majority of these animation loops, which is pretty cool. So we're just going to close this window. We're going to steal male neutral stand idol break, right click and go to asset actions, and then click on export, then name that whatever you want on your desktop or wherever. From the export options, click on export. I'm going to keep the default settings there, I'm not changing anything. I'm going to hop back into my other project. I'm then going to go to my content drawer and right click on any space and go right up to the top to import a game or character, and click on that and then select that FBX that we exported out. And you need to make sure underneath mesh, the skeleton drop down window, that this is selected on your character's skeleton, otherwise this is not going to work. Okay, I'm not going to change any of the settings here, I'm just going to click on import. Now by double left clicking on the animation, you get a preview window of the animation, so you can close that down. Now I'm going to go back into my sequencer to add this animation. So I'm going to go under my character and delete the CC underscore body rig, and then I'm going to go up to right to the top CC rig underscore BP, and then press the plus arrow next to it, and then from the pop-up menu under components, reselect the body. Click the plus next to the body, go right up to the top to the animation, go across, and this is where all your animations are kept, where you import them onto your character skeleton. So by adding that, you can see now that the animation is in my timeline. It's actually a bit short, so I'm going to expand it here, and it just loops this animation. This is a looping animation, so it works quite well. So yeah, you can see the animation is working. Now, if you want to tweak the animation, the body or pose or whatever, that's very simple to do. So you just need to right click on the body and just make sure filter asset by selection is unchecked, otherwise you won't see all the control rigs that you can actually bake to. So we're going to go to bake to control rig and then come across and go to CC underscore body rig. Click on that, and I'm not going to change anything, just select create. And then next to CC body rig, I'm going to click the plus button and select adaptive. This means we can now edit the layer of animation. So you simply just go up to the control rig and select the portion you want. I'm going to select the head and just rotate it up so it's sort of looking a bit at the camera more. Okay, and then I'm just going to press the keyframe button to place a keyframe, and then obviously I can move it as the time goes by on the timeline and press another keyframe. As you can see, you can just insert your keyframes as a layer or an adaptive layer over the original animation, so everything works really nicely. Now this is a really quick way of getting animations for free onto your character. I just want to mention that this process is exactly the same for downloading ActorCore animations from the ActorCore website. Link is in the description below. There are free animations on there which you can download. You download them as FBX. The principle is the same. You just import that in and then make sure it's attached to your character's skeleton, and then just add it into the sequencer underneath your character's body as an animation, as we did previously. I just want to say thank you so much for joining me once again. If you want to support this channel, you can hit the subscribe button. I'll be doing a written version of this tutorial on www.promptmuse.com. I also have a Patreon where I'll be doing this video in real time and answering anybody's questions that they may have about this workflow. And if you want to tag me in any of your creations on social media, I love that. It's at PromptMuse, pretty much on every platform. As always, I think that will do it. Thanks very much. Until next time. Bye-bye.